helping people that need healing. First, let me apologize for the weather. We're having a great downpour right now, but this was on my heart, and I just really had the time to do it now, and I wanted to take the time to do it. And one of the first things that I must always encourage, if you really have the love of God in your heart and you know the Great Commission is to go and help people and receive the work of Jesus, which includes divine healing, then you've got to give them a solid foundation, something to plant their feet on, a rock, something to anchor their faith on. Not to randomly say they have faith in God, but something concrete, something that is clear in the Word of God. And of course, one of the best ways to do that is to share stories where Jesus healed, or one of his prophets healed, or one of his disciples. And the story I want to deal with here today is found in Acts chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. And it's a story about two of Jesus' disciples, John and Peter, who came walking into the temple and confronted a man, saw a man that had been laid there since his mother's birth for 40 years at the temple gate begging. And Jesus had passed by there, the disciples had passed by over the years many, many times, and they go into the temple to teach, but the man in his misery had become comfortable apparently. That's an important point. A lot of people in their misery have become comfortable. They've accepted their circumstances. Or they blamed God and said, God, why'd you do me this way? And most likely that man had done that very same thing, had an attitude against God, probably mocked and joked and you know, didn't respond to God. And Jesus never walked up to him and brought any divine healing or even gave any attention to him by according to the record that we have. But in chapter 3, verse 12, after he received his healing, where he went from a cripple to a man that could not only walk, but he could leap and he could run around, he is now found in verse 12 clinging to these two disciples, so overwhelmed with joy and gratitude for the miracle that had taken place in his life. And as the people gathered together, John and Peter had to say, why do you marvel at this? It wasn't us. It's not our own power or our holiness that has done this. And they pointed the attention to the Lord Jesus Christ, whom they had crucified, and yet he was still reaching out to them, willing to forgive them of their sins and bring them into an acceptable relationship with God. And of course, great things followed after that miracle, as a result of that miracle, got this attention. But consider the circumstances. Here was a man for 40 years. He had sat at that gate. His parents would bring him there every day to beg. And while he would beg, people would come by, and there's no doubt about the buzzing of the so-called prophet Jesus from Galilee that would come into the town, but the man had no recognition for him, no response to him. Over all these years, he had just been entangled with his own little world, and in my opinion, he must have been thinking, because of the traditions of the Jews at that time, thinking that God had appointed him to this. You know, this predestined plan, that some were predestined to be blessed and other people were predestined to be cursed and be crippled and sick. And he just accepted this situation, his miserable, you know, miserable world crisis. He just tolerated it. But one day, finally, after he'd heard about this Jesus buzzing along, and now word had gone out, and he must have heard some of it, that Jesus had risen from the dead. And the church had now just gotten filled with the Holy Ghost, and there was a new outburst of spiritual rejuvenation, that all of a sudden this man saw these two men walking by him, and this time something had happened to him, and he was looking at them intently, and suddenly the Holy Spirit had never done this in the ministry of Jesus for this man. Why? Because the man was not in a position to receive from God. His heart was not conditioned yet, ready to receive. But now, all of a sudden, he is ready to receive. And he's probably heard stories, but he hasn't paid much attention. And he needs a divine miracle. This is God intervening, divine providence. And suddenly, the Holy Spirit spoke to Peter and said, look upon this man and say this to this man. Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And the man suddenly found strength in his leg, and Peter grabbed hold of him, and the man stood up, and he leapt, and he walked, and he ran around. And then, the reality of that miracle, he clung to their legs and held them, no doubt weeping and worshiping God, full of gratitude. You know, God is willing to do this for everybody if we will just place ourselves in that right condition to say, God, forgive me of what I've done in my life. I need your help right now. I may have just done things in my ignorance and my foolishness, but I believe in you. I believe you're a good God, and he is a good God. He is a merciful God. And that is a manifestation of the Holy Spirit operating as the Spirit wills. And my friends, the Spirit wills do it an awful lot more than we realize. So if you're a disciple of Jesus, ask God, ask the Holy Spirit within you to work through you and let you be sensitive so that you can look upon a man by the help and the instruction of the Holy Spirit and give them a word in season, a divine appointed word in season to bring life and liberty and healing to them.